back to Native Son, dear listener. Well, that was a much... Gilbert.
He's kind enough to bring me in a full thermos of coffee from downtown's own tasty patisserie. Just hits the spot. You all out there know what I'm talking about. Yes, you do. Oh, and Nancy wanted me to remind y'all that Tasty Patisserie is still filling orders for King Cakes for the upcoming Mardi Gras festivities. Now you tell her Remy sent you, and it's buy two, get one free. Can't beat that. So go on over there and tell her I sent you. I know, I'm not supposed to enjoy my coffee on air. Oh, Gilbert's turning red, folks. Oh, I tell you, we like to have our fun, dear listener. And that's what Mardi Gras is going to be all about. Good old-fashioned New Bordeaux F-U-E. And if I sound a little enthusiastic, well, I'm sorry about it. But I am. I've talked before about being honored to be part of the crew of knights for the 10th year running. We got a heck of a float plan for y'all, and we have spared no expense in strutting pasta. Now, this will be my first crew since my dad died last year. Dear listener, you know how important Mardi Gras was to him. God rest his soul, he was one of the crew of knights founders. He was captain for more years than I can remember, and daddy was Rex back in 1932, for those of you whose memories go all the way back then. Oh, you know, I tell you, he'd spend weeks, not months, preparing. More than anything else, it was the tradition, the feeling of being part of something, of this city that he loved so. My father believed that every man had his role to play, and every role contributed to the greater whole. Those Reds over in Russia, even the ones here at home, they try to sell that as equality. No, sir. There's always going to be a king. And each king has his name. I'll tell you, that coffee sure is fine. On the next episode, you better believe we're going to talk about this here story that President Johnson is considering a deal with the Russians to scale back our nuclear program. All that and a lot more right here on Native Son.
You doing up here? Help goes into the back.
I'm here to see Mr. Marcano. The name's Lincoln Clay.
That a fact? I'll be goddamned. Mind your manners while you're in there, boy, or they'll be hell to pay, you hear?
Why she wouldn't want to learn French instead. What possible use could she have for Latin?
Ho, ho, ho! Lincoln Clay! Christ, man, get a look at you! I bet those fucking gooks shit themselves when they saw you coming.
Been a long time, Georgie.
Oh, no shit, it's been a long time. I think the last time I saw you was that night over in the French ward, right before you shipped out. Damn, but that wasn't a gas.
Oh, I seem to remember me and Ellis running from the cops, and Danny ending up in the drunk tank.
Hell, man, I bailed him out. Besides, it was worth it to knock the hell out of them cracker assholes. Smoke?
Sure.
Oh, man.
Sammy said Mr. Marcano wanted to see me.
Mr. Marcano? Shit. Make him sound like a goddamn lawyer. You just call him Sal. Come on, he's in the back.
Something else.
Hey, these squares have a problem with your threads. You can take it up with my old man. He'll tell him to kiss his ass. Nice thing about having fuck you money.
Olivia, I hate to cut this short, darling, but I've got a meeting coming up. Remy, a pleasure as always, sir. Two more glasses. Lincoln, good to see you. This is Vito Scaletta. He's the one I've been telling you about. Come on, Lincoln, sit down.
So you served in Vietnam, huh?
Yes, sir.
Sal tells me you earned a few pieces of tin over there.
Well, I served with some good men. Nothing I did would happen without them.
Army? Marines?
Regular Army at first, and then I was recruited to the 5th SFG.
Special Forces.
I told you it was something else. Now, not that anything's gonna go wrong, but just in case, goddamn, don't you want a man like that on your side?
Well, if you're vouching for him, Sal, that's good enough for me. Look, I got a couple things to take care of. Thanks for the drink.
Christ, that guy's an asshole. Fucking carpetbagger. Commission sent him down here from Empire Bay about 15 years back. He's been a pain in my goddamn ass ever since. Well, I guess you're wondering what this is all about.
Yeah, Sammy didn't tell me too much.
Twice a year, the feds take old money out of circulation and destroy it. Over the course of the next few days, that money's gonna be delivered here to the reserve in town.
And you're gonna hit one of those shipments?
No, sir. We are gonna use that occasion to gain access to their vault.
And then steal everything that ain't nailed down. Should be $6-7 million in there, easy.
That's pretty fucking ballsy.
It's a chance of a goddamn lifetime is what it is.
Now, Vito's fronting a lot of the money for the job, and he got us the combination to the vault. Hey, you had a chance to see Danny?
No, not yet.
Oh, well, you will. We brought him and his old man in on this, and they're gonna need your help, so go see them. They ain't still in that same place.
There's something else we gotta talk about. Now, it's safe to assume you know about the problem Sammy's been having.
I took care of the Haitians. Once things settle down, money will start coming in again.
You see that right there? That's what I'm talking about. You didn't sit around with your thumb jammed in your ass. You saw a problem, you went out and took care of it. God damn, I'd take that over money any day of the week.
We pay our own way, debts and all. Always have.
Oh, hell, son, I know that. I wouldn't expect otherwise. But you know, even after we all evened up, you're still gonna be slopping around in the ass end of this city. Not much of a future in that. But maybe there's a different way forward, you understand? For all of us.
What'd you have in mind?
I want you to know I mean no disrespect when I say this. Sammy's a hell of a man, but he's not getting any younger. And I'm thinking it's time to make a change.
Well, I don't think that Ellis is ready for that kind
of stuff. I'm not talking about Ellis. I'm talking about you. I want you to run the holler.
I can't do that.
Well, look here, if you're worried about Sammy, don't you understand? Now, he's always been on the level with me. And this job we're talking about, there's more than enough for him to retire on.
He took me in when I had nowhere else to go. Treated me like a son. I'm sorry, Mr. Marcano, I can't do that to him.
Well, shit, son. I'd be lying if I didn't say I wasn't just a little disappointed. But I get it. You're loyal, which is something that is scarce these days.
Do you still want me to help with this thing we've been talking about?
You goddamn right I do! And when it's all done, you all be more than square with me. You have my word.
What do you really want to hear? That we'd kidnap and torture anyone suspected of working with the VC?
I'm trying to ascertain the level of training that Lincoln Clay received during his time in Vietnam.
Someone like that you don't need to train. You point them in the right direction, you get the fuck out of their way.
Can't see a goddamn thing.
Neither can I.
Keep looking.
Stay cool.
We'll find him.
Fuckers.
this asshole!
Goddamn massacre!
Danny and Ellis just came through with the drill!
Hot damn, Ellis, what took you guys so long?
Piece of shit drill kept overheating. You and Lincoln both still in one piece?
Yeah, we good. Where's Danny?
He's pushing everything off the side so that we have room to catch the money.
All right, well, once you squared away up here, we start driving it down.
Well, make it quick.
Motherfuckers killed the lights.
Just worry about the money. I'll deal with this.
Suspects on the move.
Help me out. Somebody help me. Over here.
We're gonna be rich, Lincoln. Rich!
They're trying to flush us out. Stay focused on what you're doing. Damn it, those guards will cut us down the second we make a break for it. Tell Danny he needs to get us out of here.
And these bastards got us pinned down. Y'all need to figure something out.
I got some TNT. I'll put out outside the hole and detonate it.
What the fuck is that gonna accomplish?
If any luck, it'll blow a hole big enough for y'all to drop down.
With any luck, Danny, do you even know what the fuck you're doing?
Come on, it's dynamite. How complicated could it be? It's lit. Get the fuck away from the hole.
No one really knows why Sal Marcano turned on Thomas Burke, but he took Point Verdun from him and gave it to an enforcer named Roman the Butcher Barbieri, who promptly busted up one of Burke's legs. Now, Danny Burke was part of the heist crew. I mean, he was a gearhead, had never done anything like this before, but Thomas Burke insisted. He figured if the heist was a success, Sal would forgive him and return Point Verdun.
Penetrator, all right.
Hey. Now, I heard there ain't nothing sweeter than Vietnamese pussy. You tell me it's true. Casanova Clay. Shit, man, it's so fucking good to see you.
You too, Danny. How's Nikki?
God, she wanted to be here, but I ain't remember how it was.
God damn, you piece of shit!
Yeah, unfortunately.
Come on, let's grab a beer. Wait for the old man to chill out, and then we can get down to it.
Yeah. What's up, man?
You already got it all set up and organized. All the girls gonna be there and everything, except we just gotta go in my cars because we can't roll up in that beat-up piece of shit outside.
Oh, you didn't just call my all-American machine a beater?
I'm just saying, there are better rides out there.
Hey, bullshit there are. This car's a beast. I dropped the custom 358 and the four shipped out.
That ain't the only thing you dropped in her. Maybe you should tell them about how you'd borrow it from Ellis and take the ladies for a ride.
Hell, man, leave me out of this. Wait,
is you fucking my car?
Mm-hmm. Nah, ain't no big deal. I was always wrapped up tight. Besides, I already got one fucking bastard in my life. I don't need another one.
All right, you know what? You're gonna clean it. Not just the back seat, every square inch. I don't need to be riding around sitting in your shit. Hey, and you, funny man, you gonna fucking help?
Like hell I am. Shit, I didn't get any.
Yeah, well, this is new.
Jesus Christ, you fucking Joker's got about as much chance of pulling this off as I do at winning a goddamn decathlon.
All right, Dad, we hear you.
Donnie and Ellis, you're gonna use the drill to cut a hole up through the bottom of the vault. You and Georgie, you'll be inside. You're to drop the money down, then get the hell out of there. That goddamn drill ain't easy to move, though. So we need a boat to get it through the canals and into position.
Well, Ellis and I worry about the boat. See, George's old man flipped the guard at the reserve, giving you his truck.
Between that and the uniforms, ain't no one gonna give us a second look. Come on, let's get moving. We still gotta swing by Skeletta's and finish up some prep work.
Hey, and you two assholes, don't think this gets you off the hook when it comes to my car. Y'all best get ready to clean it.
I ain't cleaning shit.
Hey, you cleaning it.
My father was a lot of things, few of them good. But he started out smuggling moonshine, so he knew about the canals underneath the city, and that one of them went right under the Federal Reserve. It was his idea to use a boat to move the drill into position. He was a real son of a bitch, my father. More than anyone else, I blame him for what happened. You want to stick your own neck out, fine. But leave your son out of it. It's his fault Danny died.
Is everyone in? We need to go.
We're all here, go, hurry! God, coming down through the hall. Fuck, more guys, we need to get the fuck out of here. Cops cutting off our escape route!
We'll find another way out of here. This tunnel has to go somewhere.
You don't fuck with Dougie Marcano!
You shake him, motherfuckers!
Here they come! Goddamn, take it easy! Not you, you goddamn cocksucking right fucker! Come on then, you sister fucking cunt!
Keep going, don't slow down!
Watch what you're doing! My damn boat's on burn! Come on then, you sister fucking cunt!
None of this makes any sense. That can't be how it happened.
Somewhere.
what you got, motherfuckers! How the fuck you want to drive a boat? Come on, then, you sister fucking cunt!
Keep going, don't slow down!
Fuck you, you goddamn cocksucking ride fucker! Fuck, man, fuck! Let's see what you got, motherfuckers!
Hey, punch it, Lincoln!
Are you out of your fucking mind? Fuck, fuck, fuck!
Everybody all right?
That was the craziest fucking thing I've ever saw.
I'm glad we're breathing and all, but what the hell are we gonna do now?
Only option is to head up.
Are you kidding me? There'll be cops all over the place.
Well, with any luck, they'll be too busy dealing with Mardi Gras. Notice us. Let's go.
Well, damn it, this ain't a gas.
Hey, you sure you need to grab that much of my ass?
Oh, shut up and keep climbing, man.
Okay, give me a hand. Okay. Come on.
We got you.
All right, once we get out there, I hit a payphone. Calls in a ride.
Can you walk?
Yeah, somebody give me a hand. I can get one.
It's probably just gonna be easier to carry a sorry ass. Hold up. Come here.
Hey, don't put me the fuck down!
If anybody asks, we say he's drunk. Y'all pick up that money. Let's go.
Oh, God damn it.
Hey, man, get off the phone. Right fucking now.
Hey, my time is just as precious as yours.
Y'all keep an eye out. We're in some deep shit and need your help.
Where are you?
Just off the parade route. Danny's hurt.
I can't get a car to you because the roads are closed off. Grocery store on the backside of the cemetery. Can you get over there?
Yeah.
There'll be a car waiting at the loading dock. And Lincoln, be careful, yeah? You and Ellie Sport.
We will. Sammy's having a car delivered. It'll be at the loading dock at the grocery store.
God bless the old man. Let's go.
Where you going?
Go too far, Lincoln.
Cops tell me the party's over. I'll tell you the goddamn party's over.
An untold number of federal officers were killed today when two gunmen robbed the Federal Reserve.
Fuck, you hear that? We made the news.
Shut the fuck up, Jody. We need to keep moving.
Move it, Lincoln.
For the last fucking time, you need to tell me what you did with the place.
Done told you.
French horn. All units respond. Suspects are a Negro male, approximately 6 foot four, a white male, approximately 5 foot 11, and two unknown accomplices. They are armed and extremely dangerous.
Fuck, they found the boat.
Stay cool, man. We're still good. Here can't handle his booze.
I know. I need to lay off the shine.
I say stop moving around.
How you doing? Oh, shit.
What the fuck are we gonna do?
Ellis.
Fucking pigs are everywhere.
Ellis, chill out. Everything's gonna be fine. You guys, take Danny and the money. Get to the car. I'll deal with the cops. I'll warn them off you.
Hey, no fucking way, man.
It's all right. He ain't going alone. We all got a friend, Jesus.
Amen.
All right, let's go.
Hey! Over here!
Officers investigating.
All set to shoot!
All units in vicinity be advised. Suspect engaging with on-scene units.
We need to move! Why's that man?
What's causing those screams?
Well, shit him! Get off the pot, kid.
That's a gun he's carrying!
Back me up here! Just let me be, please!
Be advised. Suspect now in a vehicle. Suspect located on scene.
Out of the way.
Careful, you dumbass.
Oh,
finding myself.
Move!
No sign here. Let's check over
there. Make way!
Got him! Back up here! All ships going down.
Take
get
cover.
Me back!
Officer request assistance. All units.
Where's Georgie?
We got separated. Before we lost sight of him, he said he'd meet us back at the house. Get in!
Responding unit investigated. On-scene officers engaging with suspect. Respond with caution.
Coming.
What's up?
I got a video.
visual on suspect. Repeat, visual contact lost.
We managed to get out of this. I'm sleeping on a bed of titties. I don't care what it fucking costs.
They gone?
Yeah, man, they done.
I knew we could pull it off. I knew it. We're rich. Fuck!
I'm robbing people with a six gun.
I fought the law,
and the law can kiss my ass.
I fought the law, and the law lost.
Well, how much is it?
A little over $2 million. Per split.
Holy mother God.
Once everything's settled up, I'm calling the man I know, having him bring over three hookers.
Boy, ain't all no right. Hooker ever stepping foot in this house.
You sure? Because two of them are for you.
I'm gonna be fucking in my new drifter.
Well, I'd appreciate that.
You know, my entire life, there's always been someone standing over me, telling me where I could go, what I could do, who I could be seen with. This. What you boys did tonight. This changes everything. This isn't just money. It's freedom. Real freedom. Ain't no one standing over me again. Over any of us. Vouloir, c'est pouvoir, eh?
Vouloir, c'est pouvoir!
Well, well, well.
Man himself.
And look at what I dug up.
You mind pouring one more of those?
Holy shit.
It'll be my pleasure.
Georgie told me shit went sideways during the robbery. Lincoln had to save your ass. You should be damn proud of that, boy.
I am, Sal. More than you'll ever know.
Oh, Jesus Christ, that is some down-home hooch right there, isn't it?
All right.
Listen, I got a guy outside. You don't mind if he comes in and packs up my cut?
Not at all.
Look at that.
Let's see if you can handle this down-home hooch.
Yeah, why don't you give me some of that?
Trying to get some corn whiskey? Make you a man.
They all the same.
Hey, take the one on the end. It's your cut, plus what I owe you. Even put in a little extra for your trouble.
Couldn't have pulled it off without you, Sammy. Y'all done right by me tonight. Mwah. Mwah. Why don't you get us something off the top shelf? We need to celebrate.
Oh, yeah. You ain't got to tell me, yeah. Bud.
Hey, fill me up. All
right.
Know something, Lincoln? You're possibly the baddest motherfucker I ever laid my eyes on. She shouldn't have said no.
Where the fuck you think you're going? Stupid fucking niggas.
Go on, grab that bag. Let's go.
When I got to Sammy's, the whole place was burning. I still don't know what brought me there that night. Luck? Divine providence? Or something else. Pulling Lincoln out of the fire, he woke up long enough to tell me to call John Donovan. So that's what I did. Most days I wish I'd never made that call.
Mr. Donovan, do you know this individual?
Sure. Sal Marcano.
Mm-hmm. And how about this man?
That's Sal's worthless piece of shit brother, Lou. Look. Enough of the dog and pony bullshit. What's your real question?
Did you help Lincoln Clay murder Sal Marcano and all prominent members of his crime family?
You're goddamn right I did.
So those the men you're gonna kill, huh?
That's the plan, Padre.
It's a dangerous course you're contemplating.
And what do you think we should do?
Sal Marcano deserves to die. I won't argue otherwise. Kill him. But let that be the end of it.
That's not enough!
It's enough if you say it's enough. I know what Sal did to you, Lincoln. But nothing you do will bring any of them back.
This isn't about bringing them back. Or even exacting some street justice. It's about making that bastard feel what it's like to lose everything. Watch as I take it all away from him.
One-way road, Lincoln. And once you start down it, there ain't no turning back.
I'm going to Sammy's to get my stuff. You ready?
I'll be waiting in the car.
Taught us kids to turn the other cheek. Not fight back. Problem is that don't work. Not in the real world.
When raindrops fall and you feel low, I'll do you everything. It's useless. Do you feel like letting go?
Lincoln, over here.
Will the world ever change? And just how long will it take to have it all rearranged?
The Padre doesn't seem too keen on the plan.
You don't need to worry about him.
I just hate to encounter any of that Catholic guilt I'm always hearing about.
He knows every low-life thing I've ever done and has never ratted me out. If I say we can trust him, we can trust him.
Fair enough. So you mind telling me what we're really doing?
I'm gonna kill Marcano and all the assholes who work for him.
Bullshit. If that's all you're after, you'd grab an XM-21, smear on some face paint, and they'd all be dead before dinner. And you sure as hell wouldn't need a tack up center and all this other shit you've asked me for.
After I got back, Marcano offered me the Harlem, said it was time for Sammy to retire. I told him no.
So you think what happened is your fault?
Hard to see it otherwise.
What do you think Sal was going to do? Host a little party for Sammy? Maybe give him a gold watch and a plaque congratulating him on his retirement? We both know there's only one way out of the life. And you still haven't answered my question.
I'm gonna take over the city, district by district. Marcano wanted me to run the Harlem? Fuck him. By the time I'm done, I'll be running the whole goddamn city.
That's exactly what I wanted to hear. Assuming, of course, you're up for something that strenuous.
How the fuck wouldn't I be?
Oh, I don't know. Maybe because you got shot in the face?
I might have lost a step or two, but it'll come back to me. Always does.
Fuck him, right?
Always does.
God, if that isn't the fucking truth. One other thing. Probably not much of a surprise, but most of the cops in this town are in Sal's pocket.
Don't always assume that.
Just being diligent. The cops see you fighting Sal's goons. They're coming after you, every time. I'll be at the motel. Come see me when you're ready.
Welcome home, son.
Now who wants to get shit-faced?
Hey, bullshit there are. This guy's a beast. I want you to run the hall.
What the fuck?
Dying over there in Vietnam.
There's something I gotta do.
I ever tell you how I got this?
Sure, you stole it.
That I did. I let the pocket of this old white man used to come around here raising him. Take this with you. There's always brought me good luck.
I can't do that.
I know you think you're alone in this world, Lincoln. But you're not. And you never will be.
Thank you.
Lord, it's hot in the hot. Damn hot. But I'm not talking about the temperature neither. But it's that too. This is the Holler Speaks. Tonight we're talking about the Hollow's own, Sammy Robinson. Not just a leader, but a source of inspiration within our community. Along with his son, Ellis, his adopted boy, Lincoln Clay. He did everything he could to support our community through his benevolent society. If someone couldn't quite make the rent, needed medicine, diapers, soon in that tragic bar fire. Boys along with him.
You weren't lying about setting up a tax center.
The key to running a successful black bag operation is plausible deniability. Which is why I stole all this shit from the FBI. Things go tits up, those chicken dicks can deal with the fallout.
Glad to see you haven't lost your touch.
If there's one thing I'm good at, it's fucking with Hoover's Ferry Brigade. And while you were convalescing, I did some digging around. Wanted to see if there are any local assets for you to recruit. I came up with three possibilities.
Right now, my priority is getting the Hollow out from whoever ended up with it.
Figured as much.
Haitians? Well, I thought they fell apart after I put Baca down.
Lucky for us, they're back up. And they're none too pleased that Sal gave Delray Hollow to the Dixie Mafia.
Dixie Mafia?
Georgie's idea. He's got him running heroin, trying to get everybody hooked.
Motherfucker. Now, I'll be damned if I let those coon asses destroy everything that Sammy built up. Who replaced Baca?
Unknown. He managed to keep his identity a secret.
Unknown? Even to John Donovan? Never thought I'd see the day.
Well, I can't help it if I was born pigmentally challenged.
So, you telling me my only option is to tail one of these Haitians? Hope he leads me back to the mysterious leader?
Hey, it's better than no options. And once you've ingratiated yourself with them, you come see me. I'm finishing something up you're gonna want to see.
Get run over! How you doing?
You're risking time in the cell, got so much.
Thank you.
of Mississippi.
Attention all units.
Judge
W.H.
Bissell has issued an injunction against the continued boycott of white-owned stores by Negroes in the city.
Heard they're flying James L. Ray back this week. Still amazes me they expect us to believe it was one man who did end Dr. King.
It's too easy. Too bad.
Let's say he was the one who shot Dr. King. Just him and no one else. What if it's really that easy to strike down a great man like Dr. King, President Kennedy, Brother Malcolm?
Then nothing in this country will ever change.
Now you struggle and you sweat and someone can take it all away just like that.
Hey there, brown sugar. You sure looking sweet today.
Just take it.
Huh? Fuck him up! There! I fucked! Wait! Gonna carve a smiley!
We all want Dixie out of the hollow. Give me your boss and I'll make it happen.
Fuck. Shit. Get to the voodoo shop. You'll find the boss there.
Sorry about the headache, brother.
coffee?
Nice trick you pulled back at the Haitian camp. Lieutenant Baca was holding you prisoner.
And I held you while dead. It appears we both full of surprises.
Certainly does.
What can I do for you, Lincoln Clay?
I want you to help me kill Sal Marcano.
I see. A few months ago, you was trying to kill me. Now you break in here and expect me to trust you?
Now that Marcano's backing the Dixie Mafia, it's only a matter of time till they come for you. And when they do, they'll kill everyone standing in their way.
Lest I hitch my horse to your wagon, so to speak.
I'll see to it that you get the hollow. After that, depends on how things shake out.
Do you know why Sammy and I were at war?
On account of you going after the lottery?
Please. Just because you don't want to face some uncomfortable truths ain't a reason to act naive. Sammy and I were fighting because the people in Dahala deserve better than a two-faced old man who handed out cans of food whenever the mood hit him. Who always did what Sal Marcano told him to do, even if it pitted him against his own people.
He did the best he could.
And yet his best didn't amount to much, did it? Once I have the holler, I run it as I see fit. No questions asked.
Long as you give me access to your muscle, your connections, and a place to hold up from time to time, you can do what you want.
Marcano replaced Sammy with a man named Richie Doucette. Do you know of him?
Assume he's Dixie Mafia.
He's a wooster. Likes to kidnap black teenagers and take them out to the bayou. After starving them for a few days, he cuts them loose, tells them to run. Sometimes he brings out the dogs, you know, for old time's sake. That's how he killed my sister. This is all I have left.
How do I find him?
It's still dangerous around here for him, so he stays on the move. But his men operate out of the community church in the old theater, Pearl as it used to be called.
It was named after Sammy's wife. I'm taking it down first.
One of my men have been staking it out. Seeing what he can learn about how it's being run, you should talk to him and see what he knows.
Once I deal with it, I'll see about the church.
You spot anything you can use?
Let me see what you got, Jackie.
The hell? Why are you driving around in a truck? What happened to your store?
Government shut me down. They don't want niggas buying guns. Where are we gonna start shooting the hell out of white folks or some such?
Motherfuckers.
Tell me about it. Let me know if you see something you want.
Lincoln, you a sight for sore eyes.
Laveau, been a while. Wasn't expecting to see you working with the Haitians.
It's either this or bow down to them fucking coon asses, and you know I ain't ever been one to bow down to anyone.
Ain't that the goddamn truth?
Cassandra phoned ahead. Say you going out to Perlis. Asshole named Merle Jackson runs it. Turned it into a brothel. Let's white fellas come in and do whatever they want to our young sisters.
How do I get to them?
You don't. Not yet, anyway. A lot of those Dixie fucks try to stay out of sight. There's someone put a bullet up their ass.
If I hit his operations, he'll have to come out and deal with me.
I got an idea how to get his attention. He got some girls locked up on the second floor of Perlis. Calls them his thoroughbreds. Has them strung out on all kind of shit. He makes a lot of money off them. Go in there quiet. Get them out of there.
I'll let you know when it's done.
Hey, I'm sorry to hear about Sammy Nellis. They always did right by me.
Mr. Laveau told me you'd be coming. The girls are upstairs. Be careful. Merle's people are all over the place.
I will. Thanks.
Carrying?
don't like the way you're looking at me.
Don't be shy now.
Run that motherfucker out.
Boss!
That is gonna smart.
And ye shall find.
Some bitch right there!
Get away, he can't see you coming! God!
Can't keep losing guys like this!
Give me that piece.
We've been looking for you. You bunch of pansies.